Good morning students. Today our topic is data visualization, and in this lecture we are going to discuss some question answer related to data visualization, especially regarding to line chart, bar chart and scatter chart. In our previous video we already discussed all these three types of charts here. So in this video we will discuss some question answer related to these three concepts: data chart, line chart, bar chart and scatter chart. So first of all, let us take a quick revision for all the concept related to this. First one is data visualization. And what is data visualization? It refers to the graphical or visual representation of the information and data using visual elements like charts, graphs, maps and so forth. Okay. Second question is, what is matplotlib? Matplotlib is a Python library, and it provides many interfaces and functionality for 2D graphics. Matplotlib is a library basically, and Matplotlib library is pre-installed with Anaconda distribution. So if you use just Anaconda distribution of Python, then you can easily use Matplotlib library by writing a statement import Matplotlib. And in short, you can call Matplotlib as high quality plotting library of Python. So it is a high quality plotting library of Python. Second, you can you always use pyplot with Matplotlib. And why it is so? So pyplot, what is pyplot? Pyplot is a collection of methods, and Matplotlib, so it is a collection of methods, or we can say that it is an interface. And as I told you that Matplotlib library provide many interfaces, pyplot is one of them. So if you use a function related to pyplot interface, then you just use import matplotlib dot pyplot dot method name. It means library name first, then interface name at second position, and that at third position you can use method related to pyplot, which also related to matplotlib. Okay, because Matplotlib contain many number of interfaces, pyplot is just one of them. And here we just use all the methods that are related to pyplot. So just use import matplotlib dot pyplot dot method name, whether it is a plot or whether it is a bar or whether it is a scatter, it doesn't matter. These methods should be related to pyplot when you use just pyplot. So basically matplotlib is a name of library, pyplot is one of the interfaces of matplotlib, and if you want to use a method related to pyplot, we just use matplotlib dot pyplot dot method name. Next, second thing, line chart. What is line chart? Chart which display information as a series of data points called markers connected by straight line. So there are different markers, and these markers are connected by a straight line segment, and this is called the line chart. After that, whatever we get is called a line chart. So these are the simple, some simple charts. One is a line chart, basics of simple plotting. First one is line chart. Second is bar chart. It represents categorical data with rectangular bars with height of the lamp proportional to the values that they represent. And you can easily see that this is a chart, basically show the information about favorite type of movie. There are five classification: comedy, action, romance, drama and sci-fi. And these are the number of the people who watch particular or who like particular type of movies. So using bar chart, we can easily find out number of people who watch or who like particular type of movie here. So in bar chart, basically information is information is represented using different bars. Next, now there are some questions answer related to this. First of all, what is pyplot? Is it a Python library? As I told you earlier, the pyplot is one of the interfaces of matplot library. Matplot is a library and pyplot is the one of the interfaces of matplotlib. So the pyplot is one of the interfaces of matplot library of Python. First point, pyplot is an interface, or we can say that it is a collection of methods. So you can use any one of them while writing about pyplot. Pyplot is an interface, that is, it is a collection of methods for accessing and using underlying functionality of a library, not a library. And the Matplotlib library has many other interfaces too, along with the pyplot interface. Pyplot is actually one of them. Next question, name the functions you will use to create a line chart. Second, bar chart. Third is scatter chart. So we just use matplotlib.pyplot.plot to create a line chart. Plot is the name of the method. But before this, we have to write a name of the library and interface. Name of the interface also. By separated by a comma sign. So just write matplotlib.pyplot.plot. And second is a bar chart, matplotlib.pyplot.bar. So bar is the name of the method. So before this, you can write matplotlib.pyplot.bar, because bar method is basically belongs to pyplot interface and pyplot belongs to matplotlib library. So just write matplotlib.pyplot.bar. Third, scatter chart. Now scatter chart can be created using two different methods. First of all, using plot, and second using scattered method. There are two different methods to create a scatter chart. First one is very simple, matplotlib.pyplot.scatter. And second is matplotlib.pyplot.plot. You can also create a scatter chart using plot method. Now, using plot method, it is to be understood. Using plot method, you can create a line chart as well as an scatter chart. But when you want to create a scatter chart using plot method, then don't use line style attribute. So if you just ignore line style attribute, then using plot method, you can easily create a scatter chart. That is the difference. And with line style attribute, you can easily create line chart. Now question number 3. Why is the chart showing one bar only while we are plotting four values on the chart? Now, first of all, this is the code here, and regarding to that code, the question is asked that why is chart showing one bar only? You can see here there is only one bar. We are plotting four values on the chart, and you can easily see that there are four value, and we have to create a chart using A and B here, but there is only a single bar. So you have to give the reason for that. Second is, what changes will you make so that the bars are visible for all four points? But do keep in mind that the x-axis must begin from the point -3. So you can easily see that in the question, you can easily see that x limit start from -3. So we don't change this value, first of all. And we have to plot a bar between A and B. So PLT bar AB is a correct statement. PLT dot show, it is also correct statement. So there is no error as far as last two statements are concerned. First two statement, there is a declaration of a list, and first list contain element 3, 6, 9, 12, and second element list contain 30, 48, 54 and 48. Okay. So there is only one chart here. And here we have to give the answer why there is only one bar here, even though there are four different values here, but there is only a single bar. And default color is blue because the color is blue of this bar because default color is blue. So that is not a matter, and even this is not asking this question. So first of all, the given chart is showing only single bar as the limit of x-axis have been set as -3 to 5. You can easily see that -3 to 5. Okay, but x-axis in the value of A, you can easily see that range start from 3 and up to 12. So if we want to find out the value regarding to x limit in the value of A, then you can easily see that there is only a single value, 3 is to be found out. Only 3. Even 6 is not that part. So there is only a single bar here. That's why. There is only a single bar here. The given chart is showing a single bar as the limit of the x-axis have been set as -3 to 5. On this edge, only one value from the data range being plotted false. Okay. So if you want to change this value, so just give the range -3 to -5, 3 to 15. And in the question, this is already given that we don't change the initial value, it means minus 3 should be there. So okay, wait a minute. Minus 3. We don't change minus 3. So minus 3 we take as it is. And the last value we can easily change it. If we want to draw four different bars here. So just give it 15 because we want to include 12 also. And if we just give 12, then as we know that last value is not included in that case. So just give 12. Okay. So we just write minus 3 to 15 in place of 3 to 5. And after the execution of that statement, you can easily plot this type of bar chart. So that is the answer. But just change minus 3 to 15. Next question. Why is following code not producing any result? Why it is giving errors? Write correct code. And note all required libraries have been imported and available. So in this statement, first of all, matplotlib.pyplot is not given here. And we considered it as they are already imported here, first of all. And the question is asked, why is following code not producing any result? So we can say that we can easily see here A range 10, 50, 12. And B range 90 220, and then matplotlib.pyplot.plot AB. Matplotlib.pyplot is we here are consider that it is already imported here, so this will not give any result. First of all, what is the this range function basically belongs to NumPy, and since it is given that all required libraries have been imported, okay, so no problem at all, we can use range function. First of all, first value starts from 10 as far as value of A is concerned, and there is an increment of 12. So after that, second value is 22, after that next value is 34, after that next value is 46. So there are four values, 10, 22, 34 and 46 as far as the value of A is concerned. So we get four different values of A here. Okay. But in case of B, if there are four value in A, then there should be four value in B also. So let us check whether there are four values of B or not. So first value is 90 in case of B. Then there is an increment of 20 because 20 is given here. So next value is 110. Then after that, there is an increment of 20 again. So next value is 130. Now after 130, we get 150. And after that 150, we get 170. And after 170, we get 190. Now these are the different values here. 90, 110, 130, 150, 170 and 190. So we get six values. Okay, so four value regarding to A and six value regarding to B. And whenever we want to just plot a chart between A and B, so there is an error because there should be four value regarding to B if there are four values regarding to A, or there should be six value regarding to A when there are six value regarding to B. So if you want to make change, then we just do only one thing. Since in B there are six values, so we just change the limit, just write 90, 160 and 20. Now there are four different values, 90, 110, 130, 150. And now there are four values against B and there are four values against A. Okay. So now if we just write matplotlib.pyplot, then we are in a position to plot a line chart, and you can easily see here that is the correct code. we just change the range here. So that is the error in this program. Question number 5. Given an ND array P as 1, 2, 3, 4 and write code to plot above chart having bars for P and P, and this is a sign of exponential here, P power 2 with red color, another bar of P versus P multiplied by 2 with blue color. So this is the output after the execution of the program. This type of output is expected. One bar is of red color and second bar is of blue color. Value of P is given. In first case, P the bar graph related to P and P power 2, and second is against P versus P multiplied by 2 with blue color. Okay. So first of all, import all the necessary library. So just write import matplotlib.pyplot as plt and numpy as np. It is also required because here we want to use array function, array method here. So first of all, p1 is equal to np array 1, 2, 3, 4. There is a list given in the question, but we take array here because we can perform here two different types of operation, multiplication and exponential. So first of all, just write q1 is equal to p1 exponential of 2, means p square here. So if there is a list and we just write a star sign here, and if we don't use double star sign here, then what happens? Actually, there is a repetition of the values. So we just here use array method. So what happens that each and every term, whatever we get after the execution of that statement, is square of each and every term. It means 1 square, then 2 square, then 3 square, and then 4 square to this minor. Okay. Similarly, when we just get q2 here, then p1 multiplied by 2, it means each and every term is multiplied by 2 here because this is an array. And we have to draw a chart between p1 and q1 and between p1 and q2. But both these graphs are basically override to each other, bars are override to each other. So we here just give a value p2, this is equal to p1 plus 0.3. Now just draw the bar chart. So first one, plt.bar, p1 and q1, graph is drawn between p1 and q1, and we take a color r according to the requirement of the question, and width we take 0.3. width is not given, but you can take here any width. So we just take width 0.3, and second part, graph is drawn between p2 and q2, color is taken as b. B means blue, so b character defines the color blue, and width is again considered as 0.3. now last statement is plt.show. So after the execution of that program, you just get that result. Next question is question number 6. Here, given two arrays, namely array 1 and array 2, each having 5 values, and create a scatter chart so that each data points get a different color, different size, and keep the marker style as square. So first of all, import matplotlib library. So just write import matplotlib.pyplot as plt. Pyplot is one of the interfaces of matplotlib. It is a collection of methods. And in this method, scatter chart is also there. So we have just want to draw a scatter chart. So just we write import matplotlib.pyplot as plt. Plt now is a alternative name of matplotlib.pyplot. So wherever we want to use matplotlib.pyplot, we just use plt in place of matplotlib.pyplot. Now second is import numpy as np, because here we want to use array method. So we just use import numpy as np. Now array 1 is equal to np dot array 1 2 3 4 5. These are the 5 values. Now we have array 1 a double r 1 which contains 5 different value 1 2 3 4 5, and similarly we have an array 2 which contains 5 different value 3 4 5 6 7. Now according to the question, we want to take different color for different scattered values. So there are 5 values, so we just take 5 different values, and we take a variable in colors first of all, and create a list, and in list give different colors names. And here you can easily see that color representation are using different characters. Okay, for example, R represent red color, B represent blue, K represent black, G represent green, and M represent magenta. So these are the 4-5 different colors here. And we take another variable size, and you can easily see that size of 5 these are the different size of 5 different scattered values: 100, 200, 300, 400, and 500. Now use the syntax of the scatter chart. So first of all, just write plt, and after that put dot operator and then scattered function, and we have to draw a chart between array 1 and array 2. So just write array 1 comma array 2, and then give the name of the colors. So we just take c is equal to colors, so all the values of colors are assigned to c here, that is r, b, k, g, and m. And the sizes, all the sizes are assigned to s, means 100, 200, 300, 400, 500, 5 different sizes are there. Marker is s, I think it is already given in question. You can easily see here, marker style as square. So we just take the marker square as star as a square. So we just give here marker is equal to s. S refers for square. And then last, plt.show. This statement we just give to show the scatter chart. And after the execution of this program, we get the output like that. You can easily see that these are the 5 different values, and these 5 different values are represented by square. And we can easily see that size of all the 5 value are different here, and also colors are also different. So this is a scatter chart. And why this is a scatter chart? Because all these points are not connected to each other by a line segment. So that is the difference between a line chart and a scatter chart here. Okay, you can take another color as you want, because in this question there is no, that is not specified that which color is to be there. And also you can take different sizes, and here we take size in increasing order, so you can easily see in the answer that there is a increment of size, increment in size of each value. You can easily see here. Now next question. Given a data frame df as shown below, and you can see here, and what we have to create a scattered graph chart between speed and meters, and between meters and weight. Okay, so there is a data frame. So first of all, to create a data frame, we have to import pandas library. So just write import pandas as pd, import pandas as pd. Second is the creation of data frame using dictionary. You can easily see that height, meter, and weight are the name of the columns, and these are the different values regarding to speed, meter, and weight here. And after the execution of this program, you can easily see that meter, speed, and weight are the different columns names, and index values are not given here. So by default it always starts from 0. So it starts from 0 and goes up to 4. Then there is the creation of data frame by statement df is equal to pd.dataframex. So after that we get this data frame, and there is a print statement which prints the data frame on a screen. Now according to the question, write code to create a scattered graph from speed and meters column, speed and meters column of df, and meters and weight column of df. So first of all, you have to import pandas as a library. Next, you should write matplotlib.pyplot as plt, because you want to draw here a scatter chart. After that, there is a creation of the data frame. Without creation of the data frame, you are not able to get the data. And if you want to create a scatter chart, so just write plt.scatter, because plt is the alternative name given to matplotlib.pyplot. And after that, put name of the method, that is scatter in this case. And we have to draw a scatter chart between speed and meter. So speed and meter are the name, are the name of the columns. So just write first of all name of the name of the data frame, that is df, and within a square bracket just write name of the column, that is speed, and comma again name of the data frame, and within a square bracket name of the column, that is meter. So if you just write plt.scatter df speed comma df meters, then there is a scatter chart which is drawn between the speed and the meter. Okay, and if you want to also print a data frame, then just write print df statement, and if you just show the result, then want to show the result, then just write plt.show. After the execution of that statement, that is the answer. Okay, you can see that these are the different scatter values given here. You can increase their size, or you can also give them different colors, but it is not asking question, so this is not required. Next, we have to plot a scatter chart between meters and weight also. So we take the same procedure. First of all, import pandas spd, just write import pandas spd, pandas is the name of the data frame. After that, import matplotlib.pyplot as plt, and after that just creation of a data frame here. Okay, just print data frame here. And now if you want to create a scatter chart between meters and weight, which are the name of the columns of a data frame df, then just write plt.scattered, and within is parenthesis just write df meters comma df weight, and always write meters and weight within square brackets. These are the name of the columns of the data frame. After that, there is a print statement regarding to data frame, and last you can easily see that plt.show will show the output. And after that we get this output. These are the different values regarding to meters and weight. This is the output here, you can easily see that. These are the different values. So in this question, first of all, we have to create a scatter chart, but we have to create a scatter chart using different values of our data frames. So we just use different columns. In first case, we use speed and meters, and in second case, we just use meter and weight as a column name of a data frame. So first of all, you have to create a data frame. After that, we already know that to create a scatter chart, we just use the method name scatter. So we just use the name of the, we just use the scatter method for that purpose. And within a square bracket, you have to mention the column name or the list or the array value. So here just because it is a data frame, so we just write column name here. And to mention column name, first of all we have to mention the data frame. So just write df meters means data frame first, and then within the square bracket name of the column. and there are two columns, so we just type df meters comma df weight. And there's no parameter regarding to the size, regarding to the marker, and regarding to the color. So you may use size attribute or color attribute, but this is not required in this question. So simple chart, scatter chart is there. You can easily see that these are the different values. So scatter chart, different points are there, but these points are not interconnected to each other when we compare it with a line chart. So that is all about after this lecture. I hope you understand. Now you are able to understand the concept of line chart, bar chart, and scatter chart after doing this type of questions. So thanks for watching this video.